were riding on horses and chariots. And the Bible says, Moses asked God, what should I do? And the Lord said, what are you holding? He said, I'm having this rod in my hand. The Lord said, stretch forth the rod into the Red Sea. And the Bible said, there was a way for the Israelites to pass through. What am I saying this morning? Our God is a way maker. Where there seems to be no way, that is where our God provides a way. This morning, God will make a way for you in the mighty name of Jesus. Jesus said something that with men, it is impossible. But with our God, all things are possible. He was able to make a way in the Red Sea for the Israelites to pass. This morning, I don't know what you are expecting from the Lord. I don't know that, yes, that maybe it has taken. I know that we serve the living God. He makes a way that where there seems to know him. This morning I pray that may God make a way for you. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, whatever you are expecting, I prophesy into your life that there should be a manifestation in the Jesus. In the name of Jesus, he's a way maker, miracle worker. He makes a way in the rest for even people that have no hope. Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you. Father, we honor you. Lord, we give you the glory. Lord, we give you the honor. Now we give you the praise, God, Jesus, God, Jesus, Father, Holy Spirit, come and take control. Without you, there's nothing we can do. Father, we need you this morning. Come and take control, come and take control, come and take control. We electrify this atmosphere with the power of the Holy Ghost. Lord, we invite your angels to come and take control of everything, Father, in this auditorium. Father, we need your power, we need your spirit. Come and take charge. Come and take charge. Speak to me, Father, to people. Father, touch the heart of me. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Amen. Put your hands together for the name of the Lord. I want us to continue something that we started last year. But I want to finish this. Amen. Now looking unto Jesus. Looking unto Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Looking unto Jesus. This morning I want us to talk on the seven principles of dealing with stress. The seven principles of dealing with stress or anxiety. And this is a case study of Jesus' life. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Oh, are you here with me?
Hallelujah.
Oh, put your hands together for the name of the living God. Beloved, Jesus is the only way. I like the song. Jesus is the only way. He is the truth. Jesus is all that we need in this life. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Somebody says something like, if you have Jesus, you have everything.
Yes.
Life without Jesus is full of crisis. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Life without Christ is full of what? Crisis. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
So he said something in the book of Matthew chapter 11, verses 20, that come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden. And I will give you what? Rest. I will give you rest. Take upon you my yoke. I like it. Take upon me, upon you, my what? Yoke. And learn from me. And learn from me. For I am gentle and lowly in heart. And you shall find rest for your soul. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
And I like something. He said, my yoke My yoke is very easy, and my burden is very what? Light. Very light. The seven principles of dealing with anxiety or stress. And we are looking at Jesus, the life of Jesus. So, classical of Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the first principle, without wasting time, is one, identification. Tell yourself that identification.
Identification.
Knowing who you are. Knowing who you are. The most crucial thing in life is knowing the purpose in which you were created. Knowing the purpose in which you were created. And this is very, very important to the fulfillment of your destiny as a Christian. One thing we have to realize is that God is a God of purpose.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
He doesn't do anything unless he planned it. He doesn't do things in any way unless he got planned it. So the Bible says he declares the end from the beginning. He declares the end from the beginning. That's Isaiah 46 verse 10. He declares the end from the beginning. And the Bible says he is the Alpha and he is the Omega. So that means our God knows everything. He knows the beginning from the end. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, amen.
Amen.
And our God doesn't do things in haphazard ways. He do things in orderly manner. He's a God of what? Order. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
I'm just trying to, build something for you to understand. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, amen.
Amen.
Put your hands together for the name of the Lord. So God is a God of purpose. Say to yourself that God is a God of purpose.
God is a God of purpose.
So he said to Jeremiah, for I know the thought that I take towards you, thought of peace, not of evil, to give you an expected end. God is a God of purpose. He doesn't do things anyhow. He knows you. Before even you were born, he knows everything that will happen from the beginning that you were born to the time that you will die. And the purposes of God concerning your life is not to give you a sad end, but to give you a joyful end, to give you a blessed end. So it doesn't matter what you are going through, it doesn't matter that your beginning might be small, but definitely I know that your end will be greater, because we serve the living God. He is the same yesterday, he is the same today, and he is the same forever. Somebody shout, we serve a living God.
We serve a living God.
Oh, I didn't hear. We serve a living God. Knowing your identity will determine how successful you will be in life. If you don't know why you were created, if you don't know how you were created, that is the greatest tragedy in life. Not knowing your purpose on this earth. I call it the greatest tragedy in life. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus knew who he was. Jesus knew who he was. So the Bible said when he came to this earth, he didn't do this anyhow. He knew he was, born for a purpose. So the Bible said he waited for 30 good years. 30 good years. If there was a time that the mother sent him to, a wedding ceremony, And he said to the people that this man's son is powerful. And Jesus said something, my time is not yet due. He knew his purpose on earth. When you know your purpose on earth, you don't rush in life. You have the spirit of patience. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You don't rush in life. You wait patiently for the Lord's appointed time. So David said, I waited patiently for the Lord. And he inclined to my cry. He drew me out of a horrible pit. Hallelujah. So when you know your purpose on earth, you don't rush in life. But hallelujah. Principles are used in all ways to make money. You know who you are, so you don't fret them. But hallelujah.
When
people are doing all sorts of things, you know, to get riches in life, you don't, you know, follow their path because you know your purpose on earth. But hallelujah.
Amen.
You know why you were created. Jesus knew who he was. So the Bible says he waited for 30 good years for his, you know, time to come. And the Bible says when he turned, when his time came, he said something that the Spirit of the Lord is upon me. Now I can declare. Because he has anointed me to preach the good news. This is why I was born. He has sent me to heal the brokenhearted. He has ordained me to heal those who are blind, to restore sight to those who don't see. This morning, you know, when you know your purpose on earth, God will do miracle in your life. God will lift you from nothing to abundant because you know why you were created on this earth. Oh, hallelujah. So the Bible says he declared his purpose on earth in the book of Luke chapter 4, verse 18. Isaiah prophesied this. In Isaiah chapter 61, verse 1 to 3. And Jesus also quoted this same quotation. That was when he entered into the synagogue, he was, you know, given this room. And the Bible said he opened that this is my purpose on earth. And he started reading that the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me. And the Bible said, from the time that Jesus said that the Spirit of God was upon him, that was the very day that the devil started attacking him. Whenever you discover who you are, that is when attack will start coming to you. That is when people will start opposing you. That is when people will start seeing all sorts of things about you. So the Bible says, Jesus said, I am my Father, I am well. He said, who are you to compare yourself to God? That you and God are one. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And they said, even in grammatical terms, you should have said, my father and myself, we are not. Why are you saying, I? So they didn't understand what's happening. Hallelujah. The Bible says, they started, you know, persecuting Jesus. Because what he said, they referred to it as blasphemy. As what? Blasphemy. Abusive blasphemy. But how can you compare yourself to the Most High God? But Jesus knew what he was saying. So he didn't murmur. He didn't shake. Well, hallelujah.
Amen.
And he said, I know that I and my Father are one. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
This morning you will start declaring why you were created, and people will not accept it. But because God has ordained it, no one can change it.
Amen.
No one can change it.
Amen.
I said, no one can change it.
Amen.
The Bible said these people took stones to persecute Jesus. But Jesus said, you don't know what you are doing. I was saying, got your time. And he said to them that, your father Abraham rejoiced to see my days. And they were saying, you're not up to 40 years, and you are saying, our father Abraham rejoiced to see your days. What are you saying? And Jesus said, you don't know. Let me give you a shocking news. Before Abraham was Ajam, this man is bold. What are you saying? Before Abraham was Ajam, declaring his purpose on earth. Declaring his purpose on earth. Beloved, I want you to, you know, put this into your
that any time that you discover your purpose on this earth, that is where afflictions, persecutions, tribulations will start filling you. Because the society will make sure they will, you know, convince and deceive you about who you are. The society will see it as blasphemy. They will see you as arrogant, pride. But I don't know what they are talking about. I know my purpose on this earth. So I don't listen to what people are saying. I don't take people's opinion to take decisions. Because I know who I am. When you know who you are, that is when people refer to you as, you know, pride. But in the sight of God, God referred to you as a matured person. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Because you know who you are. So when you say A, you don't tell, you don't go around and change it and say, oh, I intentionally said A, but it is what? C. You always stick to your words. If it is A, it is what? A. If it is red, it is red. If it is white, it is white. Because you know who you are. You know who you are. Put your hands together for the name of the Lord. So when you read the Bible says something in the book of Gospel, the Gospel of John, the Gospel of John. Jesus used this phrase, I am, seven times in the Gospel of John. Seven times I am in the Gospel of John. Because he knew he was. I am seven times in the Gospel of John. Because of time, I cannot give you all. But let me just give you the quotations. Oh, amen.
Amen.
He says something in John chapter 10, verse 11. I am the good shepherd. I am the good shepherd. Because of time. John chapter 10, verse 9. I am the door. I am the door. John chapter 11, verse 25. I am the resurrection and the life. He was trying to describe who he was. So if it was to be an elementary school in Ghana, write myself. Hallelujah. And he will start. I am the door. I am the good shepherd. I am the resurrection and the life. I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one goes to the Father except through me. And then I say, who are you? He said, you are the way, the truth. He said, you don't know who I am. When people don't know who you are, and you start, you know, talking, they will say, oh, this guy is bragging. This guy talks a lot. I don't know that you are saying this truth. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
So he said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. John chapter 14, verse 6. He said, I am the true vine. I am the true vine. I am the bread of life. Myself. Jesus was saying myself to them. Ah, hallelujah. So anytime that he stood to preach, he tries to, you know, tell people who he was. Knowing who you are is crucial to the fulfillment of your destiny. To the fulfillment of your destiny. If you know who you are, you don't do things anyhow. You don't do things anyhow. It got to a time that I call it the zero hour. The zero hour. A time in which things are not working. A time in which you see that even God doesn't exist. A time that even when you pray, you don't hear anything, you don't see anything. The zero hour. And God has also revealed this to me. That Patrick, don't worry. I'm working behind the scene. You are here for a purpose. I said, God, I know that I'm here for a purpose. But things aren't going on the way I'm expecting. Lord, speak. I was praying, fasting. I came to, you know, the downstairs, the office. And I sat there for 10 good days. Hallelujah. 10 good days. Just looking to hear something from the Lord. I was praying and God was confirming, wait patiently, I know what I'm doing. You are here for a purpose. You are here for a purpose. Anytime that I finish praying and I call people, what they will tell me, we call it opinion, ideas, suggestions. If you do this, this will help you. If you pass here, I think you can arrive. If you, hallelujah, put your hands together for the name of the Lord. Have a head in the stone that look unto me. Look unto me. I'm the author of your life. I'm also the finisher of your life. Whatever I have become, I can make it. I can make it. I can make it. I can make it. For you in the name of Jesus Christ. The Bible says, faithful is he who has called us, and he will do it. He will do it. Knowing your purpose in life. Somebody will ask, how can I know my purpose in life? It is only the Spirit of God that can reveal to you why you were created. The Spirit of God. We speak wisdom. I always say we speak wisdom to people who are mature. Wisdom to people who are mature. The Bible says this wisdom was spoken about 2,000 years ago. But none of the rulers of this earth, the kings, even understood this wisdom. The Bible said, had they known, they wouldn't have crucified the Lord of glory, Jesus. The devil thought he was killing Jesus in order to destroy his purpose on this earth. But he didn't know that he was killing him in order to fulfill a purpose. Amen. The devil didn't know. He thought he was destroying his destiny, but he didn't know that he was helping him to start his what? Destiny. Beloved, destiny is not a destination. It is an adventure. That is when you know your destiny, that is where you move from glory to glory, from blessing to blessing, from greatness to greatness. So destiny is not a destination. It is the starting point of your greatness. Let me put it in that way. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, hallelujah. So the devil thought he was killing Jesus. He didn't know he was helping him to fulfill his destiny, because it was written that he would die in order to save his people. So without Jesus dying, there is no way he could fulfill his purpose. And this was hurting from the devil. The devil doesn't know the way to greatness. He doesn't know the way to you, your greatness. He doesn't know anything about your greatness. Even though the devil knew that you will be a great person, but he doesn't know how you are going to pass in order to become what? Great. He doesn't know it. The devil knew that Jesus would save the world, but he didn't know the way that he would choose to save the world. Had he known, he wouldn't have crucified Jesus. Had he known, he wouldn't have crucified Jesus. So the Bible says, what God has prepared for those who love him, he said, eye has not seen, ear has not heard, nor have it entered into the heart of any man, the things that God has prepared for you. So nobody knows about it. Nobody knows about your greatness. Hallelujah. And the Bible says he has revealed this to us through his Spirit. So only the Spirit of God can tell you who you were created for. And the Bible says, how can one know the things of a man unless the Spirit of God that is in that person? For the Spirit of God searches all things, even the deeper things of what? God. So if you want to know who you were created for, ask the Holy Spirit and he will reveal to you. Well, ask the Holy Spirit and he will reveal to you.
Amen.
This morning I pray that may the Spirit of God reveal the word. As you were created in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Because
Jesus said something, that I'm going, but I won't leave you orphans. I will send the promise of the Father to you. And he will not speak about himself, but he will speak about whatever he will hear. Hallelujah. And he will teach you everything, even things that you do not know. So if you want to know who you are, ask the Holy Spirit. Don't go and ask your friends. Don't go and ask your father. Don't go and ask your husband. Don't go and ask your wife. Ask the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen.
Stop talking. to people about who you are. Please, who do you think I am? And they will tell you, well, you don't know who you are. You are a comedian. Hallelujah. Amen. You know, put your hands together for the name of God. Tell your friend or tell somebody sitting beside you that know who you are.
Know who you are.
Well, tell him or her that know who you are.
Know who you are.
Well, tell him again that know who you are.
Know who you are.
Well, tell him again that know who you are.
Know who you are.
And tell yourself that I know who I am.
I know who I am.
By the Spirit.
That is within me.
That is within me.
Well,
put your hands together for the name of the Lord. This point. One, if you don't know who you are, the society, the culture will try to mold you into a certain image. If you don't know who you are, the culture will try to mold you into a certain image. The society will also have a part to play about who you are. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
Number two, if you don't know who you are, you will find all sorts of people trying to tell you who you are. All sorts of people trying to define who you are. They will tell you, don't you know who you are created from? Oh, I can see this talent in you. I need you are not a prophet. You are not a man of God. How can you know the talent? Oh, hallelujah. God have mercy. Somebody say, God have mercy.
God have mercy.
You call them destiny killers. You call them what? Destiny killers. They will define you nicely. Oh, you can sing, but you yourself know that you cannot sing. Hallelujah. You can preach, but you know, you yourself know you're not a preacher. Destiny killers. Oh, you can be a medical doctor. So go and study science. Who should be someone born science? You know that you don't know anything in science. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Put your hands together for the name of the Lord. Somebody say mercy. If you don't know who you are, even your friends will try to define who you are. Your friends, your co-workers, your colleagues will tell you who you are. And the last point, if you don't know who you are, your husband, your wife will become a prophetess and a prophet, and they will start prophesying about who you should be.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
They will tell that this man, I drop a and you are aware, what's up with this kid? And you are sitting here doing this job, they be out this car, fearing the birthday. But I said to my they will start telling you. Hallelujah. So if you don't know who you are, your husband will try to define you. Go and do this job, and I tell you, become rich. Go and do this, and I tell you, and also see. They will start telling you all sorts of things. If you don't know who you are. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And they will make you like. Hallelujah. Because he doesn't know who he is. So the wife is trying to, you know, control him, moving him into what he is not. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Forcing him. You know that you cannot do this job, but because your wife said, go and do it. So you are forcing yourself to go and do that job. Because somebody did it and the best succeeded. So you are being forced into that. Say what? Work. And you will do it. And that will be the end of your life. Know who you are. Don't, I'm not saying, don't let your husband or your wife to tell you to advise you. But what I'm saying is that when it comes to the things of destiny, purposes in life, ask the Holy Spirit. Pray to God. Don't ask any man about your destiny. Don't ask any man about your destiny. That is why Jesus said something. That when the Holy Spirit comes, he will teach you all things. He will teach you all things. In the Old Testament, God said, I know the touch. He didn't say your wife knows the touch. He said, I know the touch. Let my thing towards you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Oh, amen.
Amen.
When you read the book of Isaiah, chapter 14, verse 24, this is a covenant for all believers. And a lot of us have sworn by himself, say, surely, as I have taught and planned, so shall it come to pass. The Lord was prophesying into the life of believers. And I like the verse 27, said, a lot of us has purpose, and who can annul it? Who can make it invalid? your purpose on this earth is in the hands of God, not in the hands of man. Oh, hallelujah.
Amen.
So I'm not saying don't listen to advice about people, but I'm saying when it comes to things of destiny, while you were created, don't allow people to intrude into your life. Pray to God. Somebody will do this work and the person will succeed. Another person too will do the same work and the person will succeed. It is a matter of knowing who you were created for. I know people in Ghana that are selling pure water and now they are billionaires. And I know people who are working in the bank, having their tie, their suit. They will dress nicely, but they don't have anything in their pocket. Nothing there in their pocket. It is a matter of what? Destiny. A matter of what? I know many kind of this who are, you know, borrowing. Hallelujah. Medical doctors in Ghana, when you see their shoe, you will never even think that they are medical doctors. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Know who you are. Because of our time. Because of our time. The second point. Let me talk about just 1 minute. The second point. The second point. No school approval that you were created for. You have to know why you were created for. One, knowing your identity. Two, knowing whose approval that you were created for. Let me just explain this. This is very deep. One thing you have to know as a believer, as a child of God, that you were created for something peculiar. You were created for something special. You are not on this earth to please any man. You are on this earth to please God. So you have to know whose approval you were created for. Don't do things to please men. Do things to please the Creator of the heavens and the earth. Whatever you are doing, know that you are doing it for the Lord and not a man. You cannot please everybody on this earth. No matter the life you live, no matter what you do, you cannot please everyone. Even God himself cannot please everyone. Why people are praying for, you know, winter? Others are also praying for summer. Our people are sleeping outside in Ghana. Yeah, people are also praying, oh God, this hour is too much, this winter is too much. So even God himself cannot please everybody on this earth. You are a human being, you have limitation. So know that you cannot please everybody on this earth. No matter what you do, no matter what you do, you cannot please man. So Jesus said that, Jesus said something that, woe unto you, if all men speak well about you, woe unto you, if all men speak well about you, and if all men speak negative things about you, so you cannot please everyone on this day. Notice, this is the principle of life. When you decide to please people in life, that is the starting point of your downfall. Anytime that you decide to please everyone on this earth, that day will be the starting point of your downfall. You cannot please everyone. Even Jesus himself said this, that John the Baptist came to this earth and he said, I will never eat for people to even say something about me. And yes, though, people will say he was a demon. John the Baptist said, I will not eat for even people to get something about me. But yes, though, people were defining him as a demon person. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And Jesus said, oh, okay, because John the Baptist was better than me, and he didn't eat, and people were saying he was having, you know, demon, then I'll eat. And still people were saying Jesus was a good shepherd. He was a wine bumper. He was doing this. He was a friend of God. That's what it is. People were describing God always. So Jesus was trying to say, no matter what you do on this earth, people will get something to say about you. John didn't. And they were saying he was a demon. Jesus ate. And they were saying he was a full tien. Grutunos. Hallelujah. I thought, grutunos. In Chibakila, grutunos. That is the word. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Someone who likes food, the person will eat, but still the person will be satisfied. Grotesque. Hallelujah. Yeah. So Jesus was saying, no matter what you do on this earth, people, human being, as far as we have mouth, some is round, some are big, some are small, they will say it. Expect. Expect people to talk about you. So when you talk about me, I don't care. Because even Jesus, who was the Son of God, was the Son of God. People spoke negative things about you. Jesus and Barnabas, who should be crucified? Jesus, Jesus. Or maybe they are like, he hasn't stolen anything from you. But some people were saying, Jesus. Barnabas was a great thief. But yes, the people were saying, oh, give us Barnabas the heart. Crucify him. Jesus. So no matter what you do, when you do good things, people will say negative things about you. When you do negative things, people will say good things about you. That is the way that God is. That is why human beings are. Hallelujah. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord give you the spirit that you will be able to endure whatever people will say about you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. May the Lord bless you. May the Lord be with you. Raise up one of your right hand. Raise up your right hand. Just try to ponder about the things that the Lord was saying. Know whose approval you are living for. You are not living for any.